Everyone, hope you all are healthy and safe. My advice to you would be to stay home and stay safe. Many, many congratulations to all that you all are promoted to class 10th. My humble request to you is to be in touch with studies. So I am here to teach you regarding your first chapter of class 10th mathematics, that is real number. It consists of four topics, subtopics. Number one, equalized division lemma. First of all, I would discuss the complete syllabus of class 10th, having the 7 units and their expected marks, which is assigned by the boards, is as follows. Number 1, number system 6 marks. Number 2, algebra 20 marks. Number 3, coordinate geometry 6 marks. Number 4, geometry 15 marks. Number 5, trigonometry 12 marks. Number 6, mensuration 10 marks. Number 7, statistics and probability 11 marks. Real numbers consist of 4 subtopics. Number 1, Euclid's division lemma. Number 2, fundamental theorem of arithmetic. Number 3, revisiting a rational number. Number 4, representation of rational number into the decimal expansion. Now we will start with Euclid's division lemma. It is nothing but to find out another method of SCF. In the previous class, we have learned to find out the SCF by using long division method or prime factorization method. But in this stage, we will learn how to find out the SCF by Euclid's division lemma. If there are two integers a and b, there exists a unique integers q and r satisfying a is equal to bq plus r, where r is greater than or equal to 0 but less than b. Now we are moving towards our first example. If we take two numbers 135 and 225, then how we will find out the SCF of these two numbers? For this, I am giving you the solution. A is equal to BQ plus R, where A is equal to 225 and B is equal to 135. 135 into 1 plus 90 in the first step. In the second step, 135 is equal to 90 into 1 plus 45. In the third step, 90 is equal to 45 into 25 and 225. Then how we will find out the SCF of these two numbers? For this, I am giving you the solution. A is equal to BQ plus R, where A is equal to 225 and B is equal to 135. 135 into 1 plus 90 in the first step. In the second step, 135 is equal to 90 into 1 plus 45. In the third step, 90 is equal to 45 into 2 plus 0. Where R becomes 0, then our solution will complete. Therefore, SCF will be equal to 45. Now, I will show you one more example. Show that every positive even integer is of the form 2q, and that every positive odd integer is of the form 2q plus 1, where q is some integer. Here is the solution of the given question. A is equal to BQ plus R, where R is equal to 0 and 1. Let A be any positive integer and B is equal to 2. By using Euclid's algorithm, A is equal to 2Q plus R, where R is equal to 0 and 1, where R is greater than 0 but less than 2. And if we put the value of R, A is equal to 2b plus 0, it is for even integer. If we put R is equal to 1, A is equal to 2b plus 1, it is for odd integer. Now we are moving towards our next subtopics, that is fundamental theorem of arithmetic. It states that every composite numbers can be expressed, factorized as a product of primes, and this factorization is unique. Apart from the order, in which the prime factor occur. For this, I am showing you the one more example to you express the given numbers as a product of its prime factors. Let the number be 140. This number we can explain by T's method. 140 can be break up into the two numbers, that is 70 into 2. 70 can be further factorized into 35 into 2. 35 can further be factorized 5 into 7. Now, in this way, you can solve the questions of Euclid's division lemma and fundamental theorem of arithmetic. Thanking you everyone for listening so patiently, and I hope you enjoyed this online video.